Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Dak Prescott's Cowboys going up against Ryan's Falcons.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A few moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Fielded about a yard deep.
The conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down. On first down, Ryan steps away to his left. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for. But this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about four.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Now Ryan. He's airing it out for Sanu. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And he's got Rome. There he goes, right side. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Well, it was third down defensively. They were just hoping to make a play and get off the field, get their offense on. Instead, they did one better. Pick it off, take it into the end zone.
Well, they did what you said. They got off the field.
They're going to have to come right back on.
They're going to come right back on, but happily, right? They put the ball in the end zone. That's the way you start a game. That's the way you set the tone.
And his kick is good. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. A nice little juke. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Falcons taking over on offense in just a second. And, you know, this year ended in disappointing fashion. Now, last year was the ultimate version of heartbreak, but if you're a Falcon fan, was this one was tough to swallow as well, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because let's be honest about it. Losing in the Super Bowl, I don't care how you lose, you were in the Super Bowl, you were playing for it all. This team was supposed to be as good or better. Ultimately ended up 10-6, found their way in the playoffs, but didn't get the deep run as they had the year before. So you're exactly right. For Falcons fans, that's a tough one. But this is a team that's built to be good for a long time.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Now Ryan on second down. And finding the tight end Hooper. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall right there around the 35-yard line. A Falcon first down. Ryan to his young tight end Hooper. They go play action here on first down. Sanu with a grab over the middle. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. On first and 10, it's Ryan. Looking downfield for Jones. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Here comes the D swarming to the line. Second and 10 now, Ryan. Connects with Sanu right side. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Ryan to Sanu, good for an Atlanta first down. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
23 yards on the play. And that's the connection, Ryan to Jones, that this defense obviously has to key in on.
Certainly feels like they got the party started with that one, doesn't it? And when those two get in sync.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Julio Jones from 6 yards away. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. They just get the playoff. Now Prescott. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. The first carry for Ezekiel Elliott, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for second down. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Prescott. Wide open receiver complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through, and has a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
A gain of 13 and also a first down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah.
Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Adrian Claiborne. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. A second down throw for Prescott. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A good pickup there of 20 yards. For 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there, because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back, and now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. On second down, Elliott, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Cowboys have taken the lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he will get into the end zone again, and he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the two-point conversion. Bailey now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. He juked him. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. Time a factor as Ryan will hustle him to the line. Now Ryan, flush to his right. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jeff Heath. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
They'll try the right side with Elliott. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The give is to Elliott, and he is leveled. Knocked down hard, right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on 3rd down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it, stuffed them for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And Jason Garrett's going to leave the offense on the field. They're going to go for it here on 4th. Sack, down he goes. Grady Jarrett busting through to get him for a loss of 6. So out come the Falcons now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Ryan. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Deep for Julio. It's caught inside the 25. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number 1. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on 1st down. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And with great field position here, chance for some points before the break.
That's prime real estate. Just have to decide how they want to try and take their shot to try and put those points on the board.
They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he is into the end zone. So they get two more on the board here just before halftime. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Yeah, here now come the Falcons. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Ryan. Looking deep for Gabriel. And incomplete on the deep ball. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they